They told me it was going to be, it's exactly the same exact high as weed.
When I first smoked spice, I was extremely high and extremely sick.
I started getting real bad anxiety over it.
Just a little shaking, pain in the upper chest.
Sick. I worked to where I had to sit down and just take a rest.
I just sat pretty much on a buddy's couch, and I didn't want to move. I didn't want to talk to anybody. I got really quiet.
Sometimes you feel like you're going to die.
As we did the research in our office, we learned that spice has been around for a number of years. Essentially in the mid-90s, a researcher was looking for a way to create a medicine-type drug for cancer victims. The THC, or the active component ingredient in marijuana, is what the researcher was attempting to mimic with the development of what we call synthetic cannabinoids.
What he discovered was, while he was trying to find this medicine, was something that was so strong. It mirrored the THC, but it was 500 to 700 times stronger. And it would have not been useful as a medication.
We understand that cannabinoids are in the marijuana, the natural marijuana plant, has ingredients that really bind to receptors in your brain. He's created something that binds even more tightly and can be even more concerning with regard to the impact on your brain and your actions. He actually never tested it on humans. He tested it on lab mice and found that he wasn't able to separate the adverse effects of marijuana. And in fact, the synthetic variety was even more addictive and more bound more tightly to the receptors in the brain.
Some of the street names I've heard of is Spice or K2.
Hay or Haze.
There's Twisted Spice and there's Soulless Spice.
Chiba.
Black Mamba.
And there's one stuff called Judgment Day. It really, you know, explains the name a lot.
I didn't even think about it. Everybody was on it and everybody was doing it.
For the last few years, it's been sold in places like the head shops, gas stations, convenience stores, party shops.
When I had went to the stores to go and buy it, it was incense, you know, I got this kind or this kind, this smells like blueberry.
And so this stuff's really strong.
Even in the stores that we find spice in, we don't find the little incense carriers. We don't find all these other things. We find spice and we find pipes. We don't find anything to say it, to show its use for incense.
It was kind of undercover, you know, because they didn't want anybody to know that it was being used to smoke.
The owner actually told me, he's like, yeah, it says not for human consumption. I pretty much knew that was just so that they could get away with selling it.
It's the same thing as if you were to go buy a candle or you were to go buy something else. Many of the ingredients aren't going to be listed on there because people don't smoke candles. You know, you don't put a candle in a pipe and then all of a sudden start smoking it. You don't roll up a candle in rolling papers and start smoking it. It's the same thing. Candles aren't for human consumption, but also on a candle, people don't have to list that because we all grew up knowing candles aren't for human consumption.
It's like a designer drug because it's designed only to have a specific high.
And in fact, the gentleman who was the researcher, the chemist, he's quoted as saying, smoking it is like Russian roulette.
You have an innocent herb with a very dangerous chemical that even the researcher says you'd be an idiot to smoke.